Well, it is sentencing today in a bizarre bank robbery case in Pennsylvania that wound up in murder. Remember the pizza delivery man who died when a bomb strapped to his neck exploded as television cameras were rolling? Well, today a woman convicted in that 2003 bank robbery is scheduled for sentencing. Rick Folbaum is following that case. He's here in the newsroom. Rick?
Well, John, no doubt one of the strangest cases that we have followed over the last 10 years or so. Who could forget the story of the pizza delivery man sitting on the ground in front of the car, claiming to have a bomb strapped around his neck, telling police it was going to go off? Take a listen. I don't have a lot of time, he said. Police wanted to talk to him, Brian Wells, about a bank robbery that he had pulled off, but he told them that he had been set up and that the bomb he was wearing would go off and soon. And then it did on live TV. But that was only the beginning of the mystery. It took 4 years, but police finally pieced together a plot that apparently Wells, the delivery man, was in on to an extent. Police say Wells was part of the bank robbery scheme, but that he didn't realize that he'd be wearing an actual bomb. That, prosecutors say, was the work of four other people, including 61-year-old Marjorie Diehl-Armstrong. Prosecutors say Diehl-Armstrong came up with the plot in order to raise money for another crime she wanted to pull off, the murder for hire of her own father. Diehl-Armstrong is already in jail serving 20 years for the murder of a boyfriend, a crime she says that she was mentally ill when she committed. She says that she played no role in the pizza delivery man murder in 2003, but a jury didn't buy it, finding her guilty of armed bank robbery, conspiracy, and using a destructive device. She faces a mandatory sentence today of life in prison. So finally, John, a case closed on a crime that people will be talking about for years to come. Back to you.
All right, Rick Folbaum, that was a strange one. Rick, thank you.